Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here. Today we're going to show you how to program a Honeywell 5822T wireless tilt sensor. This transmitter or tilt sensor is commonly used for overhead garage doors. You mount this device to the overhead door, and as the door slides up, the sensor goes from the vertical position to the horizontal position as the door slides. And the internal tilt sensor can detect that vertical versus horizontal position. In the vertical position, the sensor is happy. Just like when a contact has a magnet nearby, the zone would be ready. And as soon as it faults going horizontal, that would indicate that the door has been opened. So this is a very easy way to protect an overhead door. And if you haven't been aware of this sensor and you've yet to contact your overhead door because you didn't know how to properly do it, with one of the other style sensors, the 5822T is a great option for you. If you'll notice, the case design is very, very similar to a 5816. It's got a different color, but aside from that, you have the same style body with the plastic ridges. You have your arrow indicating your opening tab, and you've got your mounting plate. There's no battery along with this, there's no magnet along with this device because it's not a reed switch with a contact, it's a tilt sensor. So, to program this device, we have to pop the cover. There's a serial number sticker. We have our battery connection. We have our little tilt detectors here, which knows if it's vertical or horizontal. We have our tamper switch and we have our antenna. So that's the internal circuitry of the device. You can see right here, we have a negative and a positive printed on the green circuit board to indicate which position the battery goes. And we're using a CR123A, one of the more popular batteries used with the Honeywell wireless sensors. And we simply slide it into place, making sure to observe polarity, positive to positive and negative to negative. When we slide it in, we can see the LED lights up to indicate we have power. I'd like to point out, just like on a 5816, the 5822T does have internal screw contacts. So you could use this device as a wireless transmitter in conjunction with the tilt feature. So you could program it so it would detect from the tilting to fault the sensor, and you could program separately a wired input. Let's say you had a window next to your garage overhead. You could wire a wired contact to that window, and you could actually program two different zones, one zone for the overhead when it tilts, and then one zone for the wired input to indicate when that window was opened as well. Now that we have that learned in, we're ready to program the device. So whenever doing programming, security, more tools, and we're prompted for the installer code, which is 4112 by default. Once we do 4112, we can access the panel's programming. Once we're in programming, we see system programming at the top, and we're able to select our zone setup. Now when we do this, we hit the down arrow until we get to the next available zone. You'll see new highlighting that this is a zone that's not yet been set up. If we click edit, then we have our serial number. Clicking the serial number box is where we type in our serial number. We have our serial number shown on this sticker for the barcode on the outside, alpha 004-3494. You'll notice there's no alpha, so you're just typing in the 7-digit number. You also have the sticker inside with the same number, and those are the two ways you can program it for the serial number. Also, when this device is installed, you would have the arrow pointing up, and what we can also do to activate the sensor, or rather to enroll the serial number, is to activate the sensor 3 times. So right now, in the vertical position, we're simulating the door closed, and as the door opens, it faults, comes back down, and that's one activation. So you can see it beeped, and that would simulate that we opened and closed the door. We do that again, open, closed, and it beeps twice, learns in the proper serial number, and puts it on loop number 3, which happens to be the proper loop number to use with the 5822T. Loops are used to tell this panel how to respond from this sensor. So if we were going to wire to these contacts and we were using this sensor to take inputs from a wired contact, we would not want to use loop number 3. We would want to use loop number 1 for that zone. But if we're using the tilt switch as the actual monitor of the zone on the door, then loop 3 is what we want. To lock it in, we do one more fault, one more activation. So we go back to horizontal and then back to vertical. We see our light lights up and we locked in our parameters of the proper serial number and the proper loop number. So that is how you auto-enroll the 5822T sensor. If you had typed in the serial number, it would be very important that you remember to change the loop number. You can toggle this through the 4 available loops, and loop number 3, again, is the right one. Next thing we want to do is device type. If we select down, we can choose garage door, device type, garage door, gives us 2 available responses, garage and garage monitor. Both of these are good for overhead doors. This one will not sound the full alarm in case we only wanted like a chime in the house to let you know the door was open. If we did want it to be fully protected, we select the response type of garage. We can put a further clarifying word on here.
Overhead.
And now, when it's faulted, instead of just saying garage door, and wondering, is that the man door outside leading from the outside to the garage? Or is it the garage interior door from the garage to the house? We know specifically that we're actually talking about the overhead door. So it's important to use the zone descriptor to tell anybody in the home what's going on. Alarm report is yes. So that will tell the central station that, or rather will tell the panel to send the alarm through to the central station, assuming our system is monitored, which it is. So we want to leave that as yes. And then supervision is supervised, meaning if the panel will look for this device every 12 hours, and if at that 12-hour check-in period it doesn't see a sensor with this serial number, then it would throw up a supervision trouble indicating that the sensor's out of range, or there's interference between the panel and the device, or perhaps something's gone bad with our 5822T. Now that we have all that keyed in, we save it. And we can see here, overhead garage door is set. And if we back out to the home screen, we can verify that we've programmed it properly. So we have our sensor on our overhead door. The door is closed, so the sensor is vertical. You always want to mount it with the arrow pointing up, and then putting it horizontal, we get the fault indication, ready to arm, fault chime, fault 20, overhead garage door. You might wonder, how come the panel didn't speak that? On a garage door zone, they know that you probably don't need to hear a chime in the house for that, so it only gives you this fault. Also, a garage door zone will act as a vented zone, meaning that even though it's faulted, you can still arm the system. Normally when you have a door open, it will say not ready to arm fault, and that would indicate that you have to close the door first. With these garage door sensors, it's a good way that if the door is opened, meaning you're about to leave the house, you have your overhead open, you arm the system, you pull out, you close the door, puts it back to here, and now this is a protected zone. So that's the venting feature. And then if it was armed and it went back to here, then you would have your alarm. You'll notice if you have it flipped upside down so the arrow is pointing down, you'll get unexpected results. So right now we're showing the vertical position, but we're still faulted. Going horizontal doesn't do anything because we're still faulted, and going back to vertical may or may not restore it. So bottom line, when you're upside down, the arrow pointing down, the internal detector of whether it's vertical or horizontal will not function properly. You can see it reliably faults and restores when the arrow's up. And again, when it's upside down, you're going to get faults when it shouldn't be faulted. So just make sure when you affix this to the door that we have the arrow pointed up. So that is how you would program a 5822T to the LynxTouch L5200 system. We hope that information has been helpful, and we invite you to subscribe to our channel. And please, if you have any follow-up questions on what we've just shown you, please email us support@alarmgrade.com.